미국 동부의 유서 깊은 여자 대학 7곳을 Seven Sisters라고 부릅니다. 오늘 목적지는 Seven Sisters의 하나, Mount Holyoke College입니다. Mount Holyoke College는 1837년 여성 교육자 메리 라이언이 설립한 학부 중심 여자 대학교입니다. 아이비리그를 포함한 대학교 대부분이 여학생 입학을 허가하지 않던 시절이었는데요. 교육의 중요성을 알고 있는 메리 라이언은 높은 수준의 교육을 미국 여성에게 제공해야 한다고 생각했습니다. 그래서 탄생한 대학교가 바로 마운트 홀리오크 칼리지인데요. 80년도 더 지난 오늘날 이 대학은 하원 의원과 퓰리처상 수상자 등 수많은 여성 리더를 배출했습니다. 저도 여성으로서 이 위상 높은 대학에 대해 더 알아보고 싶어지네요. 미국의 여대는 어떤지 궁금하시죠? 함께 가보시죠.
저는 미스 코리아 USA 수상자이자 최근에 경영 대학을 졸업한 조민희입니다. 함께 미국 인류 대학들을 탐방하며 더 깊은 이야기를 들어보고 이 위대한 나라 형성에 어떻게 기여했는지 알아볼 텐데요. 준비되셨나요? 그럼 출발합니다. 아름다운 산맥 옆 코네티컷 강 계곡 안에 있는 작은 마을인 매사추세츠주 사우스 헤들리에 마운트 홀리오크 칼리지가 있습니다. 프린스턴 리뷰에 의하면 마운트 홀리오크는 미국에서 가장 아름다운 캠퍼스 중 하나라고 합니다. 식물원, 숲속 승마 코스, 호수, 폭포, 그리고 18홀 골프 코스가 있죠. 이 위상 높은 대학을 더 알아보고 싶어서 입학처장인 레이키아 씨와 이야기를 나눴습니다.
Hi, Leikia. I'm happy to speak with you today.
Hi, Jasmine. Thanks so much for having me.
Tell me about Mount Holyoke's history.
Mount Holyoke was actually founded in 1837 as the first of the Seven Sisters Colleges at a time where there were no other college options for women. Our founder, Mary Lyon, was a pioneer and a visionary, and she created a model that would later become Mount Holyoke. And that legacy of educating future leaders and women across both the United States and the world became something that Mount Holyoke was known for. Today, our legacy as a women's institution has really shifted to us welcoming students who are transgender or non-binary and female, and therefore provides anyone attending the school more opportunity to study in a truly diverse environment. But I think that we have been so thoughtful about welcoming students from myriad identities is another example of the ways in which Mount Holyoke continues to pioneer in the movement of gender equity and equality.
모든 것을 갖춘 이런 환경은 이 대학에 입학한 행운아들에게 인생을 뒤바꿀 경험을 선사합니다. 더 알아보고 싶어서 마운트 홀리오크 졸업생 한 분을 만나 학교에서의 경험을 들어보았습니다. You know, I hear that you graduated from Mount Holyoke. Tell me how you were drawn to the college.
Well, Mount Holyoke offers an incredible combination of an exceptional liberal arts education where you learn to read, write, and argue very, very well, along with a nationally competitive equestrian program. And I was a nationally competitive rider when I was in college, and so was seeking a program like that.
Can you tell me more about how, you know, the value of having an all-women's education has applied to your professional career?
I, believe it or not, did not choose Mount Holyoke because it was an all-women's college. And I know many students in my class and many students today for whom that is true, that they chose the college based on its academic prowess. And what I found as a graduate was that the value of an all-women's education came later. My first position in corporate America was in property casualty insurance, and that is a male-dominated industry. And I realized that I had been taught to think and argue and write without the undercurrent of pressure of sort of building that component into it. And so I felt much more confident in expressing myself, making my arguments, and writing my ideas than some of my female counterparts did in that industry. And I recognized that was all a part and parcel of my Mount Holyoke education. And so for me, the value of the women's education came later, but it was a very, very real value and stays with me to this day.
Mount Holyoke는 전국 최고의 학생들뿐만 아니라 최고의 교수들도 모여드는 곳입니다. 실제로 2019년 프린스턴 리뷰는 교수진 수준 분야에서 마운트 홀리오크를 4위로 꼽았죠. 젠 마토스 교수를 만나 더 알아보았습니다.
I want to know what you think about Mount Holyoke. What drew you to the college?
I worked here at Mount Holyoke years and years ago in residence life and student affairs. So I got to see campus life up close, and I had looked for other places like Mount Holyoke to work at because of the community, and I couldn't find any place that was like Mount Holyoke. And so when there was an opportunity to teach here, I grabbed it. So that's what drew me here.
Tell me more about the psychology department.
The psychology department is known for our camaraderie. So we have lunch every day, and it's not a time to talk about work. It's a time to be in community with each other. So students get to see us modeling what balance looks like. Just as we work really hard as researchers and instructors and community members, we also expect them to take that equal time to take care of themselves, just as we're trying to do as well.
Mm-hmm. That's such a sweet tradition. What are some research projects that you're working on right now?
My line of research is on Latino families and communities. And so what I'm looking at is parental engagement. And so there's a narrative that Latino families aren't engaged in their students' education. And yet there are these realities of people who I know, myself being one of them, who had really involved parents. So I'm working with students researching two different communities. One is our sister town right next to Mount Holyoke. And so there's a large population of Puerto Ricans in the Holyoke community. So we're asking them about parental engagement. And we're using the exact same questions in that community with communities in San Juan, Puerto Rico. So we're comparing what mainland Puerto Ricans have to say about educational involvement and what folks on the island have to say about it.
So do you travel to Puerto Rico to do this research?
Yes. So I am a faculty co-director of a program called Científicas Presente, which is a STEM summer program for girls in San Juan, Puerto Rico. Last summer, we brought down 8 Mount Holyoke College students to act as interns for the program. And the students were invited to join me for my research in San Juan.
Mount Holyoke has a legacy for fighting social issues. How do you think that impacts the student population?
We have courses that we call CBLs, community-based learning courses, where part of the focus of the course is to go out into the community and do research or service. You're not just studying in your classroom, you're going to take your talents and skills and service out and to help other people. And so I've seen students do that in the community-based learning courses. But if there's something that they want to do and they want to serve in a particular way and that doesn't exist, students will literally go out and create those spaces. I have a student who's from the Dominican Republic, and she created, as a college student, created a school for girls in the Dominican Republic. Being a college student, founding a school seems unheard of. It doesn't seem unheard of if you're a Mount Holyoke college student.
시인 에밀리 디킨슨부터 대통령 내각에 임명된 첫 여성까지, 오스카 수상자부터 퓰리처상 수상자까지, 마운트 홀리오크 졸업생들은 학교 설립자인 메리 라이언의 말대로 살고자 노력합니다. 나아가라, 위대한 일을 시도하라, 위대한 일을 성취하라.
So I'm curious, what excites you about Mount Holyoke?
Mount Holyoke is a really special place. Part of why I work at Mount Holyoke is because of the ability to be on a campus where students can be their authentic self so that they can focus on the things they're passionate about. Mount Holyoke is part of the 5 College Consortium, and that includes Mount Holyoke, Smith College, Hampshire College, Amherst College, and the University of Massachusetts Amherst. They offer students over 5,000 classes each semester that they can take and sort of dabble across different campus communities. And the students can travel to each of those campuses for free. students can not only engage in classwork and academics each semester, but also we share spring concerts, guest speakers, but it really just enhances the academic experience. I think all of the schools are rigorous academic places, and Mount Holyoke is definitely counted among them in that sense. But being able to find and define your own academic path with a whole slew of cheerleaders saying you can do this is something that makes us different and special.
And what type of student would you want to join this Mount Holyoke community?
I'm looking for students who are going to bring others with them and truly value partnership and collaboration. I'm looking for students who are academically passionate about something that matters to them, and that they will bring that passion with them to their campus community at Mount Holyoke.
And how can you tell from reading these applications about these attributes from the students?
Your writing is the biggest key to helping us get to know you. The way that a student writes can convey not only their maturity, but the way that they think about the world, the lens through which they see things, how they process, how they handle and bounce back from difficult situations or obstacles, and if they have a sense of humor. And that's something that we look at very carefully when we're trying to figure out if a student is a good fit.
What advice would you give these students?
The essay is the piece of your application that you can work on until you get it right to where you want it to be. And it's really an opportunity for you to give us a snippet of who you are. So think really hard about things that matter to you and what you want us to know about who you are. And so if you could take the time to bring us with you, then I guarantee your essay will be fantastic.
마운트 홀리오크를 집이라고 부를 수 있게 되기까지 많은 역경을 극복한 유학생 파올라를 만나보겠습니다.
Paola, how did you end up at Mount Holyoke?
When researching for colleges, I found myself really interested in liberal arts colleges as well as like historically women's colleges. And I went to visit, I really loved it there, and I was just like, yep, this is where I'm going after I got accepted.
You were living in Colombia. You moved to an American school and started to do your research on different universities to apply to.
Mm-hmm.
What was that process like for you?
It was really overwhelming. As a first-generation student in the United States and from a low-income background, there were a lot of things that I didn't know about, but I did have a support network that kind of helped me how to do the Common App, what the FAFSA was, other things like CSS profile, for example, and like how to understand the letters of acceptance.
What are some of the challenges that you faced while applying for colleges, and how did you overcome it?
So my biggest challenge was my essay application for the Common App. Out of all the prompts, the one that I liked the most was about like overcoming obstacles. So I was like, let me talk about how I learned English. Like that has been like my biggest obstacle. But at the same time, the essay was in English. And so for it to make sense, to make my message come across, I had to talk to different advisors. So I had all the ideas in my head. It was just like how to place it down into words concisely and just to showcase like my personality at the same time.
It seems that from your experience in high school and the whole application process, you are a type of person who doesn't want to be limited by challenges. Do you think that now that you're at Mount Holyoke, the environment provides for you to be able to continue to push yourself and find out more about yourself?
It definitely does. I feel like in a sense I've been more independent because I used to, yes, like do the things that I was supposed to and my mom would like push me. And since I started at Mount Holyoke, I am more geared towards my personal growth in terms of how to address problems and how to create a change in communities overall. So Mount Holyoke really has shaped me into a more conscious citizen, I feel like, with others than just what I want to do for me.
Mount Holyoke가 학생인 파올라의 시각을 어떻게 형성했는지 들어보았는데요. 이 학교 졸업생들이 세상에 어떤 발자취를 남겼는지 궁금해집니다.
Mount Holyoke seems to have a very tight-knit community, but I also know there's a very strong legacy for going out into the broader community to make a difference. Can you tell me more about that experience?
To say that Mount Holyoke has pioneered being on the front lines of change is not an understatement. Whether that was women's suffrage or the civil rights movement, women at Mount Holyoke are leaders and they go out to influence and change the world. And I don't think that that will ever change.
And if you had like a punchline to describe Mount Holyoke, what would you say?
Find your passion and your purpose. Mm-hmm. Often we know what excites us and what we're passionate about, but it's so undirected. And we need someone to help find our purpose and what to do with that passion. And Mount Holyoke is a great incubator for inspiring people to actually take charge of their own lives and their experiences, and moreover, to encourage one another to do the same.
1994년에 마운트 홀리오크를 졸업한 폴라 피어스는 급여가 높은 기업 보험사에서 일했습니다. 그러나 10년 뒤 폴라는 모교로 돌아와 많은 상을 받은 승마과를 지도하기로 했죠.
So how unusual is it to have an equestrian program at a college in the United States?
It is unusual to have an equestrian center of our size and scope at a liberal arts institution in the U.S. We offer this exceptional academic experience along with several nationally competitive riding teams in different disciplines that students can take part in.
Even in the position where you were a student competing in the equestrian team at Mount Holyoke, and now you're the director of the program, how have you seen it develop over the years?
It's much bigger than it was when I was here. Mount Holyoke, I think, has really capitalized on the quality of students that the Equestrian Center draws, because if you've managed your time carefully enough to be able to ride competitively and be academically strong enough to be a candidate for Mount Holyoke, then you are generally a super student. So I think that it has really been a beautiful match for the college and the Equestrian Center, is that we get great riders and the college gets great students.
What is the heart of Mount Holyoke all about?
I think that the heart of Mount Holyoke is the quality of the education. Mary Lyon wanted women to have access to the level of education that the men in the Ivy Leagues were enjoying. And then she wanted those women to push the edges of the envelope.
Mary Lyon had stated, "Go where no one else will go, do what no one else will do." How has that call resonated with you and your experience?
I started my career in corporate insurance because I wanted to be able to pay for my riding. And my shift to being the director of the Equestrian Center at Mount Holyoke allowed me to have a career that is my riding. And for me, that's what Mary Lyon is talking about. And that is what the Mount Holyoke education that I got allowed me to do. The college is about taking what you're passionate about and making it your life.
메리 라이언은 학생들에게 이런 격언을 했습니다. 종사할 분야를 선택할 때 아무도 가려하지 않는 곳으로 가라. 마운트 홀리오크에서의 하루가 저물어갑니다. 저는 오늘 만난 야심차고 독립심 강한 학생들과 졸업생들에게 많은 영감을 받았는데요. 그들은 분명 계속해서 위대한 일을 성취해 나갈 것입니다.
Mount Holyoke stands out in its community. We're going to cheer each other on to get that job or to excel in that course. That's who we're here for, is for each other.
We are here to help one another, and we are here as a greater community.
You just know like who to ask for the things you need, and everyone is really friendly, from like faculty to staff to like other students.
It's rare to be in a community where you don't have to worry about how you look or exactly what you say being the right thing, and you can really focus on what you love and finding folks who will encourage you to keep chasing after your dreams.